Thanks, Scott, for giving a great overview on how to build dashboards in Prolaborate that could really change the user experience by curating the diagrams and hyperlinks and reports and charts based on your data. So the next thing that we'll be looking at is how to define a custom form or a simplified user form so that your users would be able to focus on the right level of details that would be necessary for their due diligence or to make some key decisions. So Prolaborate's ability to read EA's metadata and the MDG technologies and let the model authors to define custom forms by just dragging and dropping greatly helps us to redefine the user experience, because one of the key points from EA model is the ability to drive decisions and due diligence by the non-modeling community. So now let's start looking at Prolaborate dashboard that Scott said. But before that, let me look at Enterprise Architect and navigate through to one of the business process diagrams and open up the properties of a BPMN activity. As we all know, there is a whole raft of tagged values that are prescribed for this BPMN activity by the BPMN 2.0 standard, and EA fully complies to the standard and shows all the tagged values, which is really good for a modeler or a process engineer to capture all these details and go to the trenches. However, this level of detail could be overwhelming for a business user who'd just like to look at a quick synopsis. Prolaborate shows all these properties by default. However, it lets the model author who builds these views to custom design forms to target to specific user groups. So let me start by defining a profile for the BPMN 2.0 technology focused on process reviewers, for example. So what Prolaborate will allow us to do is I could disable the whole technology related attributes to start with so that it's not shown to anyone. And then I could go and define a specific stereotype here. As you could see for BPMN 2.0 activity, the whole group is hidden. So I could start by defining a new group in the form, pick and choose tagged values from the list of BPMN tagged values that is shown in Prolaborate. I could specify tooltips that will be shown to your business user when he or she hovers over that particular property. This is again to further simplify the user experience. Prolaborate will also allow us to enable or disable a property for edit. Even if a user has write access, you could control whether he could edit a particular property by specifying permissions at a very granular level. And what we are also doing now is to drag and drop some custom tag values that we could define using Prolaborate as well. So once I've defined that form for BPMN 2.0 activity, I'm going back to the actual process diagram that we looked at to see how this is reflected in an end user's view. So let me open the BPMN 2.0 process diagram and then click on one of the BPMN 2.0 activity. And as you could see here, you only see the activity type, the task type, the cost, and the list of applications that are related to it as a tag value. And as you could see, instead of showing them the whole raft of tag values, this gives them a lot of focus. What Prolaborate also allows you to do is to minimize the noise in your repository browser. So by default, all the events and gateways and all the anonymous objects are shown in your repository browser. However, Prolaborate's form designer will also allow you to say which of these stereotypes would you be expected to see in the project browser. So I've just got the BPMN activity, the process, the lanes, and the participant or the pools to be enabled, in which case I'm hiding all the other intermediary objects so that my end user, when he decides to navigate through the project browser, only sees those objects that I've purposely enabled. So it minimizes a lot of noise from the end user's view. So with that said, we have done the basic configurations for Prolaborate, and the next key aspect of a web portal like this is to engage the right people at the right capacity to collaborate. And I would request Scott to walk us through how to enable collaboration to foster further engagement and harvest feedback.